Okay. And okay. Talking before we going more deeper about this topic, yeah. I would like to mention the motivation of this topic. Yeah, first the motivation is the motivation why there are some discrete probability discrete probability distribution. Why there are so many? Have you ever seen about the binomial probability distribution, Poisson distribution, hypergeometric distribution, and many more? Yeah, this is my equations. Maybe some of you already, some of you not. Yeah. And why there are so many discrete probability distributions? Why so many? Gitu ya. Remember this graph. Actually, this graph. Yeah, this graph. Focus to the function of x. Where is the function of x here? Actually, this graph is continuous, but the point is, I would like to explain why the probability distribution can be many, many, many. Yeah. Okay. Back to the figure. Yeah. Can you find another function based on this function? Can you find? Yeah, of course. The answer is it is possible to find another function because you can see here this function is not unique. You can derive, you can search, you can formulate, yeah, the probability distribution functions. It means that it can be many, 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 many. Okay? And focus to the pattern. Why the function is so many? Yeah. Focus to the pattern. You see here, this pattern is like a bell shape. And can you find another patterns? Of course. Yes. There are many patterns that can be formed. Yeah. There are many patterns possible. Yeah. And every pattern will have unique functions. So that's why it is possible. Yeah. It is possible to have many, many probability distribution, including discrete case or continuous case. Continuous case. Yeah. Discrete distribution function or continuous distribution functions. Okay. So in this topic, yeah, in this discrete probability distributions, at least we gonna talk about these two. If there is enough time, we gonna talk about the hypergeometry, but I don't know if this will be enough or not. But at least in this week, we gonna talk about the two, yeah, at least two. Because why we choose two? Because these two distribution is very much still in our daily life phenomenon, yeah. Many phenomena in our daily life that can be modeled using binomial and Poisson distributions. Okay, anyway, that's the binomial distributions, yeah. Okay. Binomial distribution is kind of one type of discrete probability distribution. So, and I'm so sorry, yeah. I'm so sorry, because I need to give you some case again for deeper understanding, yeah. Okay. Anyway, we have two cases here, yeah. First for case. For preliminary, how to say, exposure to the binomial, the concept of binomial distribution, and then after you understand about this case, I expect you to do exercise. So, I will break you in two groups, yeah, two groups to conduct this case and the exercise. You have a 50 minutes to conduct this case and exercise from now. Anyway, where is my end? Actually, this PowerPoint I already uploaded at Emas, so you can access the Emas and download the group activity. Any questions? Any questions? Any question? No? No questions? Okay. I will divide it. I already divided it into two groups and then make it also, I already enable for share screen. Fifteen minutes, please.